Wow, whoa, I actually nearly fell. Wednesday, 27th of November, 2019, I was interviewed on the TTT Now Morning Show. Why, you may ask? Well, my short film, The Lagahoo, which was selected for this year's Trinidad and Tobago Film Festival. Last month, in October, my short film was aired on TTT as part of their local lineup of short films called Lil Flicks. Well, it's November and they're airing it again, so they invited me to be on the Now Morning Show to talk about my film and to promote it, and also to talk about myself and my channel. So, that's what this interview is. I don't want to keep you guys any longer. I hope you guys enjoy.
But remember, TTT is all about living for local. And my next guest is Riyad Rahman, filmmaker. And you are the filmmaker of Lagahoo. Welcome to the program.
Thank you. Thank you so much for having me.
Good to have you. But you are known for comedy.
Yep.
But this sounds like a horror because it's Lagahoo folklore. Tell us all about it and how you end up there.
Well, first off, this is a film that I created last year.
Yeah.
And I have my own YouTube channel, right, which is my platform where I upload my films. So since like 2017, I've been making films on my YouTube channel and I've grown my audience and everything. And we actually just hit 10,000 subscribers on the channel. Thank you. So like I said, I'm kind of known for comedy, but I always like to try new things. And like, even when there's a challenge or something like that, I always try to like push what I can do.
Mm-hmm.
And the complete opposite of comedy. I thought I wanted to do something different for Halloween last year.
Mm-hmm.
So up until 2019 this year, I filmed on my phone.
Right.
So this film was actually on my phone.
Ah, okay.
Right. And I mean, I don't really let my limitations get the best of me. So I thought I wanted to do something local for Halloween. And like, I guess a folklore story is like right for the taking.
Right. You know? So what research did you do and how much work did you do to get the story correct?
Well, I chose the Lagahoo because it's a no budget film. You know, and that by itself has like a lot of limitations. You know, if I want to do something else like a sukunya, that involves like a ball of fire, like
right, yeah,
like you know. So, the Lagahoo was a creature that I could create a story on, and like not necessarily you have to see, mm-hmm. like based on like what it's about and everything.
Mm-hmm.
So I thought that might be the easiest thing that I could possibly create, mm-hmm. and the kind of quality that I wanted to bring as well.
Mm-hmm.
I thought that was probably the best thing I can do.
So which one do you prefer now that you've done both comedy and thriller horror?
It's funny because I actually don't like horror.
Me too. I would hardly watch a horror, really.
Yeah, no.
But I have worked on an activation for The Nun,
mm-hmm. yeah.
the film, the actual film, The Nun. And that was about, well, of course, The Nun, mm-hmm. the story. And it's similar to the story of Shikari Island. So we had to film there in the night,
I remember,
in darkness. But when you're filming, you're actually filming, you're not actually experiencing the horror because that comes
it's
in post-production.
It's way different on set than the final result.
You have all the crew and everything there. Mm-hmm. So how large was the crew? Did you have to? You said it was no budget. So was it just you filming and the actors?
So it's I've kind of been a one-man crew.
Yeah.
Me, my cousin Shazid,
yes.
who's the other actor, and then props to my dad for being on our road at midnight.
Just
two of us running around with cameras, you know, and doing
our
thing.
But independent filmmaking, though, it's it's very exciting.
Yeah.
Frustrating with the finances, but exciting when you're doing it, right?
Yeah, and especially the audience's reaction when I uploaded it, because the entire way through, I'm like really doubting myself.
Yeah.
You know, wondering if like I crafted the suspense right and all that kind of stuff. And then even when I uploaded it, everyone's like, "Yo, you really scared me." I'm like, "Oh, thanks."
That's good. You know? So how long have you been making films then?
I've been interested in filmmaking since like 12.
Yeah,
I've had my channel since like 12 years old, and I've uploaded videos since like 2012.
Yeah,
consistently, inconsistently, kind of. And only in 2017 is when I started to gain some kind of like traction.
Yes.
And when I saw that coming, I just kept going and going and going.
Yeah. And who are some of your inspiration behind the work that you do? Who do you look to for inspiration?
To be honest,
I just do you. It's all in your mind.
It just comes to me sometimes.
And you write as well.
Yeah, I write. I have to pace up and down. My dad always makes jokes. He said he's glad that there's a wall in my room because I would just keep walking when I'm writing. So
You write on literally.
Pretty much.
Okay, so the film. Tell us what the film is about, and then we'll say when you can see it here on TTT.
Right. So The Lagahoo. It's a story of just, like I said, simple story. Something we were able to do, but I guess pushing the boundaries of what we can do. So it's just a simple story of someone walking home, and then the whole concept of the Lagahoo is hearing chains dragging behind you. And of course, every time you watch back,
there's something there or there's not something there. And then, well, of course, there's that feeling of like paranoia.
Right.
Like, is this someone messing with me? Is this actually like the creature it is? And well, yeah, the conclusion is.
All right, so to find out more, you have to look at TTT this evening, Wednesday 27 at 8 o'clock. Remember, it's Live for Local, our stories right here on TTT. But talking about our stories, our story in studio right now is when I ring this bell, our guest is invited to select a star from our tree. It's part of the Seafront Lions Christmas Star Project, and they're bringing Christmas cheer to 500 children from Kokoreet Primary School all the way up to Point Kumana on the seafront there. And we asked our guests to pick, and you can pick as many stars as you like and bring the gift back on December 6th, because December 11th is when they take Santa to the schools. So go right ahead, Riyadh, and you choose while I ring the jingle bell right now.
Well, I do like red, so I think whatever is closest to red.
Okay.
I will take Uno.
Yes.
And I guess I might as well take a blue one.
I'm loving this. Okay, so you got, let's see who you got. You got Jaden, who's 7 years old, and Maria, who's also 7 years old. So you're going to keep this, and
keep this.
You can drop back the gifts here at TTT for Seafront Lions. That's so wonderful. Well, guys, you know, we're coming to the end of the show. We have the band Jamwa Collection, who's been with us all morning. They're going to give us the full performance of Thank You, Woman. Remember, make a difference today now. I'm Lisa alongside Carrie. This is where we bring down the curtains. Thank you, TNT Ferry Service, for bringing these guys to us. And of course, for all of you looking out there, thank you for joining us. We'll see you tomorrow. I'm a collection.
Woman, you are queen from beginning. The potent show the world. The love that's in your soul.
Oh, yo, 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 yo.
Now try to fit in a slay magazine. Try love the universe. Abundance is your worth. So don't let nobody criticize your body.